Daily Monitor.
Who told you that I sacked Mbabazi? I just appointed a new prime minister.
And was that done because he posed a threat to your candidacy?
No. We have had how many elections in Uganda? I always get competition. Competition cannot be a problem at all.
Many Ugandans would say, though, that there was quite a bitter competition for a power struggle, as it were, for power within the party.
Power struggle. If somebody's engaged in a power struggle, that's a problem. But competition is different. Power struggle is like intrigue. Because if it is competition, then it is according to the rules. There must be rules which are followed. So the speculation, Museven sacked Mbabazi or what, is wasting your time for nothing. These are our party issues. You just watch, you will see what will happen.
I mean, nevertheless, it was quite a public and bitter breakdown in the relationship between the two of you, and your relationship went back more than 30 years. How difficult was that for you?
We are not in public affairs for emotional reasons. These are not emotional arrangements. These are issues of mission. So when you are in a mission, there's nothing personal. You are just given an assignment, you do it by your party. In this case, it is a party. That's all. So there's nothing emotional about it.
It does bring us, though, to the question of succession leadership. Are you planning to run?
That is for the party. You have heard of what people call a party?
The question here is whether you're planning to run in the 2016 election.
It's not me planning. That's where you are now mixing it up. It is what my party wants and what the country needs. You sit down as a party. In this case, we start with the political parties and we assess what does the country need and what can the party offer. And then who among us can? That's how we have done it all these years.
There has been talk that doesn't seem to be going away, that your son is being groomed to take over from you. What do you say to that?
That is an insult to me. Why should I groom my son? This is not a monarchy. This is not a feudal arrangement. It is a democratic order. The people choose whoever they want. And why should I waste my time that I'm grooming my son?
I mean, you say that it's not a monarchy, but there are several members of your family that are in quite high positions. There's your brother-in-law, who's foreign affairs minister, your brother, who's a senior presidential advisor on defense, your wife is a minister for the Karamoja region. There's a number of family members that are in quite high positions. Surely you can understand why people have questions around that.
My brother, who is a general, went through fighting, and fighting is not a privilege that you confound somebody. It is a sacrifice. He joined our struggle when he was 16, was injured very badly. That's why he's in that position you are talking about. It was through the struggle, sacrifice for the country. My wife, against my advice, joined politics and was elected. That's what you call democracy, including disobeying husbands. That is all democratic. The other one, brother-in-law, that one joined politics long ago, before my son married his daughter, had nothing to do with the marriage of my son to his daughter. He was already a politician. So unless you say the son of a politician should not marry the daughter of a politician, that's when we can guarantee against that. But otherwise, it has nothing to do with the family.
Can you understand why, for some people, it is a concern?
My wife, after defying me, she had the biggest majority in the whole country. She won with the biggest margin of all the members of parliament. What more democracy do you need?